Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're doing a feature spotlight on Miro, an online collaboration whiteboarding tool that we're going to dive in on and how it is being used by teams and focus in on five specific features. Now today's video is a partnership with Miro, so you can check them out in the link in the description and sign up for free today and find out more as well. So for this feature spotlight, I've picked out five features inside of Miro that I've been impressed with and want to highlight and talk a little bit about how they're suitable for asynchronous and remote work as well, and a little bit about that real-time collaboration too. Now inside of Miro, there are bunch of features. The first thing I think that is quite helpful is the templates ability. Now, when you go and create a new board inside of Miro, you are met with a range of options. And that's because they've created these things called templates to save you a bit of time. You can actually go ahead and create a blank template or use one of the pre-filled ones that they've created. And one thing I really love about the experience is that you can actually preview each of them and zoom in and look at the details of it before actually committing to use it. Now, templates save you a bunch of time because they sort of help you with your own productivity blockers, because sometimes one of our problems with productivity is we actually look at a system and we want to build it, but sometimes that's quite tricky. But templates just help you to remove some of the noise and get you rolling versus stopping and sort of being that blocker for your own productivity and your own team productivity too. So the one thing you can do is explore something called community templates, and it's actually called the Miroverse. And essentially inside of here, these are templates built by people already using Miro in their respective industries. And it's amazing because you can find so many great use cases in here, from Salesforce all the way to Deloitte, and even a design sprint board created by the writer of the book, Jake Knapp, which is crazy. So Miro is really a nice experience for being able to set up templates. And if you're in the business pricing plan, you can actually create custom templates, which helps save you time, so you can save that template for the future if you and your team want to replicate it. So the second thing is the brainstorming abilities. And inside of Miro, this is obviously one of the core experiences for team collaboration. And what's really nice is you can do asynchronous collaboration, meaning you can just sort of play sort of time tennis with people. So you could do a bit of work and then they could pick up the work. And asynchronous is very popular with those who are looking to be a bit more flexible with their work schedules in particular. But you can also do it in real time too, and we'll talk about the meeting features in a moment. Now, the one feature that I think is probably one of the favorites in team collaboration and brainstorming is the ability to sticky notes on the page. Much like you would in person, you can create these sticky notes and add them anywhere you like across the boards. And what's cool is a lot of templates lean towards creation of these sticky notes for better online collaboration together. One great example of this is the team canvas template that there has been created, and it is marvelous because you and your team can break down goals and objectives and use this as if you would do if you were in the office, which is perfect for remote collaboration and taking that step further. One other feature I like in the brainstorming abilities is commenting. This is something you can still use asynchronously, but it helps you to, for example, just leave light notes for each other for be able to respond in particular to certain elements of the board. Now, meetings are a pretty helpful part of Miro, and they help you to really just collaborate in real time or asynchronously around a specific topic. And there are so many different meeting templates on Miro. There's even these ones called smart meetings, which are pretty cool, and I'll come to those in a moment. But you can connect up your existing stack like Zoom, the likes of Microsoft Teams, WebEx from Cisco, and more recently Google Meet as well, for collaborating with your video chat tool. And you can use that in a team plans and above. Now, what's really nice is once you've got on a call with people, you can actually invite guests as well, which is great because if you're using some of the smart templates, which are basically templates created by consultants and the more advanced sort of setups, specifically in smart meetings, this is something that looks super professional when inviting guests to boards and for inviting them when they're specifically real-time collaboration as well. So what's really nice, just before we move move on from meetings is the icebreaker ability. It's fairly new, but you can play these as sort of micro games before or after meetings or in between to break them up a little bit and get your team really engaged in a like company culture, which is really nice because that's something that quite lacks in remote environments as well. And these micro games sort of help you get started too. So next up is planning. This is something in Miro that I actually didn't know much about before checking it out. And they have Gantt abilities, which I did know about, but you can also use a template like Monthly Planner for being able to project stuff ahead and allocate stuff to other people. And this is a really nice function. One template that I adored was one called the Mountain of Tomorrow, which helps you to visualize your goals over the coming year and beyond and help to project that onto a visual of a mountain with lots of guidance. And these are one of these more advanced expert templates that you can get started on too. Finally, diagrams are a great way to collaborate on stuff. And sometimes we naturally think of diagrams as these things that we need to get in person to like be able to visually map processes and systems. But actually, a lot of the time, it's necessarily the technology that's in the way. But something like this, using the flowcharts, can be really, really helpful. And in particular, creation of any of the shapes is really easy inside of Miro. But I really liked the jobs map, which helped you to break down a specific task and really use the sticky notes and collaboration and some of the more flowchart stuff to really break stuff down into its more actionable items. So I mentioned I'd talk a little bit about personal productivity, and there's lots of personal productivity tools inside of Miro, especially in the templates area. But what's really nice is if you're a solo business or you are starting out as a freelancer, this is a great place to collaborate on ideas and thoughts without necessarily inviting other people. But if you did, there is that extension and that ability to expand if you do want to add more team members to the process. So thank you very much for stopping by. Hope that gave you a little bit of an insight into how Miro works for real time, remote and hybrid collaboration. I'm really interested to hear what you think, but you can check out Miro below and find out a bit more about the pricing plans if you're looking at teams. But just get started for free, which will be linked below. Miro has over 35 million users worldwide and is one of the most popular online whiteboarding collaboration experiences. And it's really well known in companies. So you can tell that when you go in the Miroverse, because some of the community templates developed by really big popular names like Salesforce and Deloitte and many more. So folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope it gave you an overview of some of the features in Miro, and I hope you subscribe to Keep Productive as well. So make sure to check us out in the link in the description. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.